Coming soon to Barutiwa TV. After the end of the Civil War, citizen journalism from a Black American perspective became rooted in the 19th century South. Freed men and their children had an insatiable desire for learning how to read and write. As a consequence, the post-Reconstruction period produced a prolific number of Black Americans who were founders of highly vociferous newspapers. These editors and their reporters often organized in the face of great danger. This first generation of free Black Americans were unwilling to return to slavery and demanded that the rights of freed men and their children be respected. It is from this background that Ida B. Wells pursued a career in journalism with an emphasis on championing the voice of her people. Ida B. Wells Barnett was born a slave in Mississippi on July 16, 1862. She learned how to read and write from attending the schools organized by the Freedmen's Bureau. Her career in journalism began in 1894 after the lynching of three of her friends. She reported for the Free Speech, a newspaper that she partially owned. After criticizing the local whites in an editorial for murdering her friends, the office of the Free Speech newspaper was burnt down. Ida escaped to Chicago, Illinois, while she was only hours ahead of the lynch mob. This experience hardened her and increased her resolve to continue writing against mob action in favor of rule of law. The same year, 1894, she married Ferdinand L. Barnett, a lawyer and journalist.
In July 1900, Ida took a personal interest in the race riots that engulfed New Orleans. The racial strife culminated into a deadly shootout between the New Orleans Police Department and Robert Charles, a former slave. Ida's investigative journalism produced a report proving that Robert Charles was not a common criminal, nor a desperado. She successfully argued that the NOPD was completely unaware of him, until the night Charles refused to submit to a billy club whipping by Officer Mora. Ida's report documented the untold atrocities carried out against Black New Orleanians by white criminals during the seven-day manhunt. She even concluded her report by condemning the NOPD for provoking Charles and forcing the man to fight to the bloody end for his life.